Okay, thank you for introducing me. It is 4 a.m. in Japan now. So let me start my talk. The title is The Impact of NDA Free Open Source on LSI Design and Fabrication. And I am Akita from Japan, Kanazawa University. So, and also, and also I appreciate to have a chance to present my project in the open source for open source hardware community. Thank you very much. So this is the outline of my talk. Let me introduce about the background of this project related to the Moore's law, you know. And also let me introduce next day. Let me introduce about the my project of NDA free open source LSI design and fabrication project, including its design rule, libraries, and design flow and example as well. So at first, let me review about the Moore's law about the in terms of the hardware. You know, the Moore's law is a trend that is predicted by Gordon Moore in Intel to predict that the number of transistors on single chip will increase drastically by year and year, and also it requires the continuous size reduction of the each transistor on chip. So so next let me review what this Moore's law achieved. Of course, the result of the Moore's law is the increase of the computing power of the supercomputer and so on. But there is another aspect of the computing paradigm in Moore's law, such as the spreading of the application of the computer, such as the gaming computer or smartphone or home appliance and game gadgets and so on. So there are two phases of the in the Moore's law. One is the faster computing and the other is the so fast computer in everywhere or ubiquitously. So we can consider about this point that about the paradigm shift in LED blinking paradigm. Of course, the traditional method to implement the LED blinking is oscillation circuit, of course. And also, in recent years, many people will implement the LED blinking by using the microcontrollers like Arduino and so on with very simple software. But in currently nowadays, by implementing to implement the LED blinking on PC is possible, but it is not realistic because its cost is very expensive. But since the microcontroller is very cheap, so there are no reason to there are no reason to avoid the microcontroller for LED blinking. Of course, it has a high functionality on it. So this is one of the result of the Moore's law in the paradigm shift of LED blinking or spreading the computer applications. This also implies that the feature size reduction of the transistor is not the only way of the Moore's law or the technical trends. And also, let us consider about the negative aspect of the Moore's law. You know, the currently the prices of the cost or the cost of the LED design and fabrication is very expensive and expensive. For example, shuttle fabrication service is about $1,000, where the design tool is too expensive, about $1 million, and also it requires a non-disclosure agreement for designing and the chips. It is priceless, and of course the facilities is very much expensive. So the drastic increase of in the LSI design and fabrication cost is a negative one of the negative aspect of the Moore's law. So in the NDA, we have to engage NDA with the LSI fabrication facilities or companies or shuttle service companies, so to receive the needed information to start the design or to fabricate the chips. So So since there is a very restricted NDA, we cannot share the designed circuits on GitHub or as open source hardware. And also, we cannot fork the designed circuits by others because of the existence of the NDA. So this is NDA is one of the most severe and important problems to make the LSI designed as an open source. So I have surveyed one problem about LSI chip is a tool for everyone. So this is a YouTube movie I have made, and this is the procedure of the designing and fabricating the LSI chip, designing the custom LSI chip to only to implement the LED blinking. And also, I want to look at the comments for this movie, and there are so many comments of this movie. Most of them says this is stupid or waste of technology or in Japanese. So from these comments, we can see that the LSI is not a real tool for realizing everything. Or something. LSI chip is a very expensive tool to implement a very high functionality chips or system and so on. This only is a way to use LSI chip for realize the application. So from this point, we can find that the most people can't imagine to design the original LSIs because it is too expensive or too complicated or no experience for most of people who have designed the PCB or microcontrollers or about 3D printing model and so on. But few of them have any experiences on designing the custom LSI. So most people simply consider to buy LSI chips like a microcontroller, sensors, and so on. And of course, there are a lot of things can be realized by commercially available LSIs, but intrinsically there are very severe restrictions in thinking or creating an idea of the system implementation. We only think about using the existing LSI chips, so we cannot imagine to design the original chips for any purposes or any purposes. So, for example, we can use the Kinect for motion capture or gesture recognition, so on. So, and everyone can use the Kinect, but few can invent Kinect because there is a custom chip in the Kinect system, especially in the sensors. So this can be considered as losing the chance of the innovation, possibility of innovation. So I think that the LSI should be a real tool for everyone to realize any kind of the applications. I have surveyed what is required to realize this purpose. LSI as a tool for everyone. There are three problems to be solved. One is the CAD tool, EDA tool. Currently, it is very expensive in commercial tools, and also they are very complicated systems. So difficult to handle it. And the second is the fabrication services. There are several commercial services to fabricate the design custom LSI chips, but it is too expensive, and also it requires a too long turnaround time. The time from the designing to get the fabricated chips for more than several months. And also, I have mentioned. As I have already mentioned, that there is very strict NDAs to start the design and fabricate the chips. And also, there are a few user committee in the LSI chips. There are, of course, there is a very specialist community, like a researcher or engineers, LSI chip designers. But they know how to design it. But they most of them do not know or do not have any interest in what to use the LSI chips. So the lack of the user committee is one of the severe problems of the realize world of the LSI as a tool. So I am organizing a very small project, so-called Make LSI project, to share the open source freeware cards and knowledges of designing and fabricating chips. And currently, I am now organizing a committee on the mailing list of over 150 attendees, including the LSI specialists and the non-specialists or hobbyists or software engineers and so on. And also we are organizing or designing NDA free design and fabrication ways. Let me introduce some of them. One is the design rule. We developed a 1 micron grid design rule without any NDA. And this is a very rough and thick wire design rule. But by using this rule to design any chip layout designs, we can fabricate the chips for some fabrication services with the same rule. We have already operated two fabrication services in Japan, and also we are now planning the Chinese 0.35 micrometers process and so on. So, and also this rule is independent on FAB's limit of design rule, so we can use this rule and the circuit using this rule for without NDA, so we can share the design and so on and reuse it. And also we have developed some libraries to be used in the LSI chip design, and including the standard logic cells and analog components, and also and they are developed by a few contributors, not only me but also the other contributors on using the GitHub system. And also we are finding some tools to design the chips. Most of them are open source softwares, and there are free and open source layout tool and circuit simulator and logic synthesizer and place and route systems. And this is a this is an example of the RISC-V processor designed by the open source software Qflow system using the open source source codes of the RISC-V processor. And this is just a subset of the RISC-V processor. And also we are also looking for some ways to fabricate the design chips. There are two ways, Fintech Semiconductor in Japan and Hua Hong Grace in China, which we are now preparing to try it. There is a project so-called minimal FAU project by Advanced Institute of Science and Technology in Japan, which uses very small 0.5-inch wafer and maskless exposure, and it realized 1 week turnaround time to get the design chip with a very low cost. So in the future, maybe we will be able to order the custom LSI like a PCB or a fusion PCB and so on. So we can get the design custom chips with about 5 or 10 thousand US dollars around. We have already tried several times to fabricate the designed chips with several contributors, free view for with so and open and share contents of the design circuits. There are a wide variety of the circuits depending on the each contributor's interests, analog circuits or a very small digital circuit or computers and so on. And also the contributor has a very high and hot passion to activity, so this is a motivation for design their circuits. This is the second one, and there are several similar ones. So let's summarize my talk. I have reviewed the effect of the Moore's law, a positive effect and a negative effect. And the negative effect of the Moore's law that is a drastic increase of the cost and requirement of NDA often restricts the application area of the LSI chips, custom LSI chips. So we have to we can extend the possibility of the LSI technologies for main users to realize any kind of the applications by using the custom chips. So we are now developing NDA-free and open source LSI development project to share the compute design knowledges and the design circuits and so on. So this is my talk. So this please give me a discussion on this Discord channel. Thank you.